Jmix is a set of libraries and tools to speed up Spring Boot data-centric application development. Jmix provides a lot of ready-to-use functionality out of the box. You can plug system functionality like advanced data security and audit, as well as business functionality like reporting or business process execution engine in a few lines of code. Jmix Studio IDE simplifies development by providing specific code generators, refactoring, and intention. The IDE is based on the IntelliJ IDEA platform used by the majority of Java developers around the world. You can easily install the Studio from the IntelliJ Plugins Marketplace. For this tutorial, we'll create a simple project management application. This application will allow us to create projects, tasks, and assign tasks to users automatically. Let's create a new Jmix project. We'll use JDK 11. With Jmix, you can generate project code based on templates. To create an application, let's use the single module template. Assign a name and set a root package for your application. The Jmix tool window allows us to get access to build scripts, configuration files, data store settings, data model, some UI settings, and a predefined roles list. Also, we can add some project-specific objects and define project properties. The navigator gives us the access to Jmix add-ons marketplace and documentation. The newly created Jmix application has all the necessary functionality: a user entity and user repository to store the application users in the database, the login screen and user management screens, admin role permissions description, and initial database schema creation scripts. Jmix uses Liquibase as a database versioning tool. The database schema creation scripts are stored in DB-agnostic Liquibase XML format. Let's move further and create the object model for our project management application. With Jmix, we always start application development with the JPA data model. Jmix Studio provides a visual editor to simplify JPA entity creation so you don't need to remember all the rules and annotations. Right-click on the Data Model node in the Jmix tool window and create a new JPA entity. The first entity that we'll create is Project. Let's add attributes to the entity: name, which is mandatory, start date, finish date. For the project, we need to define a manager. Let's make a mandatory link to a user entity. This is a many-to-one association. Please pay attention to the instance name field. This is the entity's attribute that'll be used to show the particular entity in the user interface. We'll use the project's name attribute for this purpose. As you can see, the entity designer has generated a pretty standard JPA-compliant Java code for us. Let's create the next entity, task, with the following attributes: name, which is mandatory, task assignee, a reference to a user, and mandatory, start date. Estimated efforts. The amount of hours should be positive. The task cannot exist without a project. This relation is called composition in Jmix. Let's create a link between a task and a project. Open the project entity and create a composition attribute, tasks, the list of tasks within the project. To make a link to the project from the task entity, we need to create an inverse attribute in the task. The data model is ready, so let's generate database update scripts. Jmix Studio generates update scripts by comparing the existing database schema with the application data model. The studio may ask us to apply existing scripts to align the application and the database state. Then, we can see the generated scripts in the pop-up window. Every application needs an admin UI to manage data, security, and so on. Jmix Studio provides a CRUD screen generator that'll allow you to perform all the basic operations over data. Let's create screens for the project data management. We need both a browser and an editor screen to view and edit projects. When you fetch data from a database, you always need to decide whether or not you need to fetch the associated data as well. For example, for the project entity, we need to fetch information about its manager. In Jmix, we use fetch plans for this. The fetch plan is a definition of an entity graph extracted from a database by an application. You should use it when selecting data from a database with Jmix. In most cases, a default predefined base graph is enough. But in some cases, you need to display additional information about an entity. Let's add manager for the project browser screen. For the project editor, let's add both manager and tasks fields. It'll allow us to edit a project and its tasks on the same screen. A back office UI screen consists of two parts. First, the XML layout defines the screen appearance and data binding. The second part is a controller written in Java, which is responsible for internal screen logic and events handling. UI components can be bound to data in a bidirectional way. All changes in the bound fields are reflected in the selected data and vice versa. Now, let's generate CRUD screens for the task entity. With the task, we'll also fetch assignee and project entities. The application is ready for the first start. Just press Run in the IDE to start the application. You can see the application log in the studio's Run window. After some time, you can access the application using the browser. Let's open the URL and log into the application using the username admin. The password is admin by default. Let's create some test data. First, add a project and assign the admin user as a manager. Now, we can add a task to the project. Let's add a task and create a new user, dev1, as an assignee for this task. Save the newly created project. Tasks will be saved automatically. In Jmix, you can create roles and give them permissions to access the application data, such as particular entities or attributes, or functionality, like screens and menu items in the admin UI. Let's create a role developer and allow developers to edit task estimated time and start date only. Also, let's add another role to the developer, the minimal access role that allows users to log into the application. Then, let's assign the role developer to the dev1 user. Now let's log in as developer1. We can see that this user has access to the specified screen and attributes only. Now, let's create some business logic. We need a service that'll return the least busy user. In the admin UI, we'll use this service to assign a task to this user by default. To do this, we need to create a Spring service and define a query that will return us a user. In the service, we'll use the Jmix service data manager. It allows us to access data by using a JPQL query. Let's implement a JPQL query that'll select users and count tasks assigned to these users. After that, we take the first user in the selected set. Now, we need to invoke this service from the task editor screen. In the screen controller, we need to subscribe to the initEntity event, which is invoked when a new entity instance is created. Let's inject the service and invoke it in the event handler. Assign the execution result to the assignee field of the created task. That's it. Let's restart the application and see the service execution in action. First, let's add one more developer, Developer 2. We have one task assigned to Developer 1, so an admin or Developer 2 will be the next least busy developer. After that, the next least busy developer will be either admin or developer 1. They both have one task each. The simplest way to deploy a Jmix application is to make an executable file and run it in a server with JDK installed, or create a Docker image that runs this executable jar. Let's create an executable jar and run it. To do that, run the boot jar command in the Jmix Studio. The file is ready. Navigate to the folder and run it, executing the command java jar. Now you can open the browser and see the application running. With Jmix, you can implement a ready-to-deploy Spring Boot application in minutes thanks to the powerful development tools and code generators. You can find more examples and tutorials on our website, jmix.io. Thank you for watching.